All right, hopefully this is my last part. Let's talk about these three biblical principles. Let's talk about praying in unity. Let's talk about the prayer of agreement. And let's talk about praying in faith. Praying in unity. Let's go back to the book of Genesis, chapter 11. This is where you had a group of people who were unified, one language, and they decided that they were going to build a tower that would reach heaven so that they could make their name great. Okay? Now, of course, God has a problem with that because God is already in opposition to anyone trying to make their own name great. So God says, nope, he does not want them to do that. But if he does not do something about what they're about to do, then nothing will be impossible for them. In other words, they're going to be able to accomplish what they set out to accomplish because they are unified. Because God understands that there is power in unity. And so does a lot of believers who know how to get their candidate elected. All right? Now, let's move to the next one. The prayer of agreement. I want to look at Mark 11, where it talks about that when you pray, let's go to Matthew 18, that talks about that if two or more touch and agree in the earth, that what they are believing for will be given to them. So in other words, if you can get at least two people to come into agreement for something, then whatever they are believing for will be granted to them. Again, the same people that want their candidate to win understood this 4 years ago, and they understand it today. And that's why if something is not done about it, they're going to get their guy in again. And then the last one, praying in faith. Now, this is where I want to use Mark 11. It's actually Mark 11, 24. It says that when you pray, believe that you receive it and you shall have it. Again, there is power in prayer. We pray in unity, we pray in agreement, and we pray in faith. Those who got their candidate elected 4 years ago understood this, and that's why they stood over their candidate and prayed over him before the election and even after the election. And they're going to do the same thing this year because they know what a lot of folks don't know. And that's why I'm sharing this with you. Voting in the natural has to be done. But just doing what you can in the natural does not necessarily accomplish your will. You have to do what you can in the natural, which is to go out and vote. And then you have to call on or touch or bring into existence those things that are in the spirit realm through unity, through the prayer of agreement, and through praying in faith. If you don't do the super and add that to your natural, then the supernatural will not be accomplished for you. Can everybody at least understand that? It's going to take more than just voting to get your candidate in office during this election. All right? Can everybody understand that? All right, that's it.